Let's continue our learning. What we have learned in the last class? Yeah, about the golden swan. Who are the two good friends here? Ramu and Shyamu. What problem arise among them? They found a golden swan, and who should it belong to? Let's continue. Okay. Let's finish it today itself. Okay. Page number 8. All of you take page number 8. So last class we heard about Tenalirama's suggestion. What did he suggest? He suggested that we shall sell this golden swan in an auction, and from that auction we get some money. By using that money we can build a beautiful garden in the main street of our kingdom. That was the suggestion Tenalirama put forward. Okay, let's continue. Okay, so in the textbook you can see the picture. Opposite of that we can begin. Okay, it should have a fresh water fountain and shady trees. So he suggested to build a beautiful garden in the main street. And also, what all things needed in that garden? It should have a beautiful fountain. What do you mean by fountain? Waterfalls. And also shady trees. What do you mean by shady trees? The trees that give us shade. Under that we can take rest. That was Tenalirama's plan. Travelers from around the world should be able to rest there. The travelers, the foreigners, the people from other regions, other country, they can come to our kingdom and they can see all the things in our country. After that, they can sit under these shady trees. They can take rest under these trees. That will be a great blessing for the travelers if we do so, Tenalirama said. One more suggestion he put forward. What was it? We should have a pillar in the garden on which the wonderful story of these two selfless and generous friends should be engraved. What do you mean by selfless? Selfless means unselfish. That means not a greedy thinking. Selfless. Selfless means unselfish. So, Tenalirama suggested in the midst of the garden, we can place a pillar, a stone pillar. On that pillar, we have to engrave, E-N-G-R-A-V-E, engrave. What do you mean by engrave? Engrave means carve. So, if you go to a museum, if you go to a park, if you go to a monument, there you can see something written on the stone pillar. Have you seen that? Yes. So, like that, in the midst of the beautiful garden, we have to place a pillar. On that pillar, we can engrave, we can carve the name of these two friends. Who are these two friends? Ramu and Shyamu. How are they? They are selfless friends and generous too, kind. So, we can engrave these two generous friends' name on that pillar. It was a good suggestion Tenalirama put forward. Okay. Thus, their exemplary, what do you mean by exemplary? Exemplary means good example. Another word for you, exemplary. Exemplary means good example. So, when the people go through this pillar, they can find the beautiful example, the good example. Friendship will become famous and be remembered for generations to come. The coming generation, the upcoming generation also, they watch this pillar, they can see these two friends' name, then they can understand it's the good example of true friendship. It was a very good idea, no? Thus, Tennali Rama put forward a good suggestion in front of the courtiers. Okay. Last passage. Both the friends were very pleased. What do you mean by pleased? Happy. They become happy to hear the suggestion. The king and the courtiers praised Tennali Rama. What do you mean by praised? Congratulated Tennali Rama. Focus on the greater common good. Common good means it's good for all the people. It's good for common people. So, Tennali Rama's suggestion was accepted by king and all other courtiers because it was focused on the well-being of both friends and also to all other people in the kingdom. Okay, have you understood the story? Yes, it was a beautiful story. From the story, we can understand the true friendship and also one more thing, honest. That's, we have already heard the proverb, now honesty is the best policy. So here also, these two friends followed the honest way. So in our life also, we have to follow the sincere way, the honest way. That we should follow the true way, okay, not the crooked way. So, and also when we choose friends, they should be good friends too also. Then only they are helping. Then only we can love each other, share each other, care each other. So, select good friends and be humble and honest in your life. Okay, that's the message that I am giving you through this lesson. Okay, so let's do the exercise. Okay, take page number 9. So, last class we have already discussed 4 questions. So, once again I will repeat it. Okay. Read the words aloud. Assembled. Assembled means gathered. Awestruck. Surprised. Tilling. Plow. Possessions. The things belongs to. Rituals. Religious ceremonies. So, we have already learned these in the vocabulary, no? Okay. Answer orally. Who was the rice farmer? Who was it? Ramu. Next, B. Take the correct answer in each. What is the name of the king in this story? What's it? King Krishna Devaraya. So, you can put tick mark. What were the two friends carrying? Yeah, a golden statue of a swan. Who offered a part of his land to his friend? Ramu. Who was the witty minister? Tennali Rama. Last question we haven't discussed. Tennali Rama was praised for his focus on the dash. Cunning behavior of two friends, greater common good, expensive golden swan. What's the answer? Yeah, greater common good. That means for the good of all the people in the kingdom. Okay, so you can put tick mark in the correct answer box. Exercise C. Number the following sentences in the correct sequence as they appear in the story. So there are 7 sentences. So in each box, we want to put the correct number in order. We have to arrange those 7 sentences in order. That means you can put correct number. Which comes first? Then which comes second? Which comes third? Like that, you can put the numbers in each box. Okay. That's your homework. Okay. So, that's your homework. Do it at your home. Okay. But before that, you must read the lesson 3 times loudly. Then only you can find the answers correctly. Okay. First of all, read the chapter 3 times. Then only answer it. Okay. Put correct numbers in each box. Okay. So, we shall meet on the next class. Thank you, children. Bye.